see the suspects package these bricks up well, as if they already have a buyer in mind. But this house is actually not slated for demo. And now this is what neighbors have to look at.
I've never known them to demolish house, so I didn't know how they did it. But then I begin to watch. I said, okay, they're doing something they're not supposed to be doing.
And Detroit police say Marion McCall was right. And today, Detroit police busted three people, two men and a woman, for allegedly stealing bricks off of this house on Clover Lawn that is owned by the land bank. Neighbors and the people who showed up in this pickup truck that says it's from Brick World first showed up late last week and tried telling them that they had permission from the land bank to take the bricks.
They showed us some paperwork, which
did it seem fishy to you?
It did not have anything relevant to the address that's under investigation.
They are frustrated because they have to live next to this, and the people don't have any kind of concern for the citizens at all. It's all about profit for them.
Police said the paperwork the suspects produced appears to be bogus, but what is very real is the eyesore they left behind for Miss McCall, who has kept her house tidy for over 40 years.
They shouldn't come and destroy our own neighborhood. Look at how bad that house looks next to my house.
And we were able to talk to one of the suspects as he sat in the back of a police scout car. You'll hear what he had to say coming up on Action News at 6 o'clock. For now, reporting live on Detroit's west side, Kimberly Craig, 7 Action News.
And you got to hope the land bank is going to clean that up for the neighbors that still live there.
It really is unfortunate. Hey, Carol, I got to tell you, these people are picking this house apart. And then right across the street, somebody fixing up another house.
All right, Kim. Thank you so much for the live report. We'll talk to you at 5. All right, let's head outside now for a live look over the Motor City. We've got some showers taking aim in Metro Detroit. Let's check back in with Chief Meteorologist Dave Rexroth to let us know what we can expect out there tonight. Dave?
Tonight's going to be all right. If we're going down to the ballgame, we'll check the Tigers forecast coming up a little bit here. But you can certainly see clouds thicker south and southwest compared to north and northeast. Matter of fact, a little bit of sunshine has popped out here pretty strongly, and that makes a difference on temperatures. I see what's going on in the north here. 63 in Lapeer compared to 57 in Monroe, and 63 in Port Huron compared to 56 in Avon. So sunshine makes a big difference, especially this time of year when it's really